It's the 2nd of December. My name is Andrew, and I'm here with my friend Andrew. And this is another segment of Andrew and Andrew Go Hunting,
aka Make Mac Attack.
Boom.
Well, we'll see what happens up here, up in Johnny's upper shanty. We were out this morning and last night. Mac Noon got one down. I missed a buck. But you learn valuable lessons when you mess up, and that's what I did. So, overall, morale's still high. You're still in the woods having a good time, no matter what you do. So just enjoy it.
Tika 308, shooting 180 grain bullets. It's a pretty good gun until today when I missed. But it's not the gun's fault, it's the man behind the gun. You gotta remember that.
I officially stink. There's no doubt about it. I reek. I hope this doesn't affect my hunting in this box, but it should. But I just thought I'd let everybody know that it's tough to have good hygiene when you're hunting every day. Just think about that.
Have you taken any showers this week?
I rinsed my body once. No deodorant, obviously. Shampoo, no. I gotta get that Scent Be Gone shampoo or something, you know, something like that to help me out. Because if you have any recommendations, put them in the comments. Because right now, it's bad. It's just bad. Release the power of the Haichu. Dun, dun, dun.
Something over there. I can't tell. I think that's right there. No, that's not it. Is that it? There we go. We see a buck. Looks like a nice 6-point. Walking straight towards us. That's a nice buck. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Yeah, no brown times, I don't think.
Very nice buck.
Alright guys, if you're watching this video, obviously I saw enough to make it an eventful evening to make a video out of, so stay tuned. Because if I don't see anything tonight, there's no reason to even make a video. But at the end, I plan to also pick up my trail cameras and then post those to see what has traveled through the property during the season. So it is the last day, the last few hours of the season. Been a lot of shooting in the morning, probably some does. The neighbor did get a nice 8-point. I'm gonna head up to the upper stand and hopefully we can see a nice buck, because that's all the tags I got left. All right, so I'm up here in the upper shanty and I don't know if things are gonna start moving or not, but after it gets dark, stay tuned, because I'm gonna go get those trail cameras. And we're going to go through them, and I'm going to put on video, in this video at the end, everything those cameras captured that's worth looking at in this video. I have one that is on video, and I have two that are on 3-burst snapshots. So we'll see what happens. Gives you an idea of what's going on. I'm hoping that maybe my dad, that big buck that my dad saw, is on there. And maybe even before he shot. I don't know if it's going to be on after he shot, but there's one camera behind me, there's one out in front of me, and there's another one way out past where my cousin Rob shot that big 10-point on opening day. So stay tuned. So like I said, if you're watching this video, something happened, or there's at least something worth videotaping. We got our first deer coming out. Small doe. Alright, it's been about an hour and a half, and I got the second deer, and it looks like another fawn. Both look like young deer. That's good, as long as they're staying in the food plot. That means the deer are moving. It's been pretty rough. But I mean, the whole time I've been here, I've been watching deer, but it's the same two young fawns. I spoke too soon. There's a deer coming out right now. That's it for the rifle season. I didn't even see a buck. Normally we're going crazy because we can't see any doe, and all I've seen were doe and possibly button bucks all evening. Lots of shooting all around this evening, last day. Probably deer drives, getting last minute doe shot. So we're going to go through these trail cameras. These are Browning trail cameras. I had one set on a video mode, two of them set on three burst shots, set at 1 minute intervals, I think. And I set these out around the middle of the rut. I wanted just a couple weeks of them sitting out before the rifle season started. Now, these were not in high deer movement areas. The top of our hill, picture of it as an oval. So you have two long ends and two shorter ends. We have two guys on each of the short ends and two guys on the opposite end. My dad's on one side, Ron's on the other, my cousin's on the one end, and I'm on the other. So out of all that hilltop, there's a few places the deer can kind of get by. If you're not watching 24/7 on that one little spot there, they can sneak through. So I put trail cameras in places that most likely are not the high travel routes, just in case I see anything cutting through back and forth, back and through. Which doesn't mean that we still won't see some of these deer on the camera, but it's more for intel and for me to learn what the deer are doing during the rifle season. So I try to put these in chronological order. So we're going to be bouncing around through three different cameras. These Browning trail cameras, I think two of them are different models. I don't even think they make the models anymore. So I think one was like a Recon Edge or Dark Ops. I can't even remember the names of my own cameras, so or make some models. So we're going to go through these right now. All right, the very first picture is, obviously, you can see the date, 11/8, so we're in the best week of the rut, almost. I killed a Pope and Young buck on the 8th. This buck right here, I killed on November 8th. And then I killed that one there. Let's see. On November 3rd.
We're in a good section where the deer are moving. They're still in rut. And if we look here, we see a small buck. He looks small, but this is actually the buck that my cousin Andrew and his friend Andrew saw. This buck is on the same trail where that deer came out of, so obviously he's running that for at least a couple weeks. He's running that same trail. Here it is later on at night. I'm thinking maybe my time was wrong, because at 11 p.m. that should be a lot darker. So I think the time is wrong on that. That's probably right at dark, probably more like 5 o'clock or so. That's the same buck. Obviously, he's with a doe, it looks like there, I think. And that's the edge of an old strip job dry pond that I have the trail camera on. Here he is again. He's running the whole way around. This is on the next side of the hill. Just wrap around just a couple hundred yards, and there he is again, middle of the day. And we're just 2 days before rifle season, so we're gonna go into right before rifle season. This is up by my cousin Robbie's. This is a section where he would most likely see some of these deer coming through, and I believe he did see this buck. Remember him saying that he saw a half rack, so that's probably it there. This is right before rifle season again, on the other side of the hillside. There, nice buck moving right before dark. Looks like a nice 8-point, but you could tell there's a deer way, way in the back, and he must be, I can't tell if that's a buck or a doe. It very well could be a buck, but regardless, they're moving right before dark. Now here's opening day. First video that took something. So obviously those doe were getting spooked. And then here is opening day of rifle season in the afternoon. This is the buck that my dad shot at. Yeah, tell me about it. It was heavy. Looks like a 10-point. Good sized deer. And I had a second picture of this deer and I accidentally deleted it. I kicked myself for that. But that was right. That's the big buck that my dad shot at. Okay, and then we're going to go back over where we were just at, over by my cousin Robbie. So we look at that, it's 312, and then quarter to 5, we have this video. And then we're back over where, after my dad shot at that buck, and he grazed it, we're looking for blood. This is probably, I don't know, maybe 100 yards from where the shot took place. We know the deer ran past here, but the camera never picked up on the deer because it probably was going too fast for the trigger time of the camera. We're not 100% sure. We think we're just following track. We had already lost blood 50 yards by now. We're just going off tracks, and there's a lot of downed trees and stuff, so we figured it came down into this area and tried to hit this trail to try to get back to wherever it came from. And obviously you see me with the camera thinking we were going to find it or something, and right now we're just looking for blood, and we never did find anything. So now we're going back. We're going to go. This is through the middle of the week. I just got a little tiny buck here, 10 o'clock. And then if you notice, the bucks are starting to, the big ones are starting to stay at night. This is a nice big buck. This could be the buck that me and my cousin saw on the first week of the rifle season, but I'm just not sure. Looks like a really nice buck. So there, that's soon after opening day. Here we got another video. Not much with that. We're into December. So on the 1st, this was a Thursday, and this is the buck that my cousin saw that was with me, and later on he came by this trail camera. Big 7-point. Really nice buck. Then here's that buck that my cousin Andrew saw again, a little smaller, it has that messed up side. Here he is again. Now we're into the 4th. See, the 4th would be Sunday. So this is Sunday. A big 7-point, you know, 4:30 in the morning, he's moving through. And now we're back onto some video back towards my cousin's stand. December the 5th now. There hasn't been a whole lot going on. There's been lots of doe coming through these cameras. Little tiny spikes and 4-points and stuff. Anything that was legal, I tried to keep if it was rather visible to see. There were legal bucks that come through, and here we're towards the end of the whole season here. So this is now, it's like, hey, rifle season is almost over, so we can just be done walking around at nighttime. But what I noticed from my intel, what it tells me is we have our stands in the right places. That's what it tells me, because we're not seeing a whole lot of other things in different places that we may or may not see. And if the camera does catch them, we have seen them from the deer stand. So that's a good thing. They're following the deer trails as we hope that they would. They're not just following and then veering off and cutting a 90 degree turn out of who knows what scent or sound or who knows what from walking into the stand. So it sounds like we have our deer shanties in the right places, and that there's a lot of nice bucks around. And be ready, because I got a late season video I'm going to be making. We're going to look at more trail cameras, because we're going to find out what made it through the season. And I'm already surprised, because I already know partially of what made it through the season. So stay tuned for that video coming up.